Have you found that any particular strains that the people you're getting, that actually they like?
I have. And throughout this process, I've been able to preserve that strain. You know, the strain that I found is good for certain things. It may not be good for other things.
Well, I know some med patients in Canada that they like Williams Wonder for a lot of people that have like irritable bowel or fibromyalgia or a few other issues.
Well, the thing is the federal government has deterred any research money for cannabis.
Yeah.
For medical purposes or anything, actually.
It's like the report they censored for 20-some years from the University of Virginia about how cannabis destroyed cancer cells.
Yeah.
And then the only reason half of us found out about it was because Spain did a similar study, and it came out, I think, in 2003, where they came out and said, oh, yeah, it does this. And all of a sudden they said, oh, yeah, and there was another study. But because that was a government-funded study, they could suppress the information.
Yeah.
And I mean, as a taxpayer, I'm outraged at the fact that my government will pay for a study, have a study that shows product that should be available to any cancer patient, and then you're going to sit here and suppress this and classify it or eliminate it from public, you know, ability to be viewed. I mean, that's censorship. I thought we lived in a free society.
Well, they do it all the time.
I mean, you look at it, you had DEA's own judge, Judge Young, who came back and ruled against the DEA about pot being harmful. And I mean, and so they overrule their own judge.
Right.
I mean, these are the guys that they're so crooked that they get something they don't like. They just keep on going like no one said anything until they get some other politician who's worried about his image.
Right.
You know, the fundamental again. I mean.
Well, that's pretty much what I was saying before. Is that all the talk has stopped about it?
Yeah.
You know, they're not going to commission any more reports or none of this stuff because the more that's done about it, the more leans towards the legalization side.
What do you think we can do in Maine that would actually make a difference?
We're going to run another petition, I believe, on the medical aspect of it.
Okay.
And the hemp aspect of it.
How many signatures?
We might just even put a clause like they do in some of their bills. We might just add a clause to the medical bill that we don't need federal permission for growing hemp in the state.
That sounds good to me because
I'm
about to butt out.
Yeah, so
it's a main issue.
So if they can add clauses and stuff like that, you know, down there to sneak things in, then we might try it too. But anyway, we've come to the conclusion that the legislator is not going to, you know, fix this medical marijuana bill, so that the people are going to have to do it again.
Have you found that since Baldacci became governor that things have gotten a little bit less helpful, or, I mean, was it better under Angus King when he was governor? Or?
I don't know. I think it's a little better
myself,
but you know, Angus King, when he came in, we had pretty good hopes for him with his rhetoric about the overflights were intrusive. Well, you know, after he got into office, what made him any less intrusive? Because, you know, he started ordering them, you know, a year later.
Yeah, I thought that 18-month war hiatus was nice, but then he put them right back when he was up for re-election.
Well, either that or the feds, you know, got under his collar. And
here and allow Canada to sit here, like you said, sell 80% of their hemp to the United States for manufacturing or food processing or however using that particular hemp product, whereas we could be having American farmers profiting. I've heard figures as high as $400 an acre for hemp. I don't know if it's $250. It's quite a lot because if you have a limited stock, price will go up. I mean, it's just simple economics.
Right.
And I much rather see, I mean, in Maine, you have a limited growing season, so you're really limited in how many crops you can get in per year. You know, hemp would stifle the weeds. It's great for aeration of the soil. It's a wonderful product. And what's funny is they don't allow the farmers to have any say because the DEA wants to completely keep everybody out of it.
Disagree with me. Please give up. You already lost the fight. remind you of the process. Anything you might say.
Get out!